So welcome, comrades. Today we will speak with comrade Rafał. The subject of our conversation is how to build the communist movement in Poland. Hello, Rafał.
Hello, comrade.
So, comrade Rafał, like me, is a founding member of the Polish Workers' Party, and it is the construction of our party that will be the topic of our conversation. First, I would like to ask you who you are, what is your social background, where do your parents work, and where did you grow up? Where have you worked so far, and what is the job market in Poland like for a young man like you? And finally, what made you interested in communism?
So I'm Comrade Rafał. I come from a countryside. I live in countryside in Greater Poland. Wobojście is in the west of Poland. It is mostly rural area. So my both of my parents are farmers. During my childhood and to 18 years old, I helped my parents in working in a farm. So it was hard work every day. After I turned, I end my primary school. I go to a university to study accounting, and I must live on my own. I go to work to Amazon in Wrocław, and it is constantly hard work in my life. So what I can say.
Maybe I will interrupt you now that for people who know Polish language, we recorded video about your work in Amazon. It's one of the most popular video in Odrodzenie Komunizmu channel. Now it is more than 5,000 viewers. Because you, in this video, you are said the truth about the hard work which is there. Many people work there, many people know that it is hard work, but people, most of them are the cowards who don't want to speak about the truth about this reality in this work. And your video was very interesting. Could you say more, summarize? Say something about your job in Amazon. How did you? Were you recruited then?
So after I end up my school, and during my school I helped my parents in a farm. I go to the city, and it is also hard work in Amazon. Because my parents didn't have money to rent flat for me or pay for my studies, I must work and earn money. It was very simple. I sent application via email to Amazon, and this same day they called me, and next day I was in this magazine in this building of Amazon, and it was day zero, they call it. It was very simple to use scanner to where is some place in this Amazon, and it was constantly work during a week. I work in Amazon, and in weekends I go to the school, which is paid in Poland. So I must pay it every month for my study, for my studies in university. And from Monday to Friday, I work in Amazon.
Okay, so now when you know who you are, you didn't ask what made you interested in communism?
So if when in my area which I come from, the people are not interested in politics if it comes to young people, or it is right wing youth people, because in Poland we have many propaganda in internet, in television, which makes young people to believe in capitalism, in success, in if they will hard work, they will have everything they want, and maybe they will become millionaires one day. So when I was young, I believed in this propaganda, capitalist propaganda. And I thought that my hard work at farm, at Amazon, during my studies, it will, and I will end up like in a corporation, and there might be 10,000 zloty. It's very, very big money in Poland, but it was not true. After Amazon, I end up in some company. I was a young account worker here, and it was paid less than work in Amazon. It was very hard work, because you can't make mistakes here, because you feel some still some Excel files, and you can't make errors, because it will have very very it will end like your boss will come to you and what I want to say. The second thing, that it was mobbing here. I was constantly people yelled at me, people give me to do something, give me a task, and I don't know how to do this, and if I ask someone, they don't want to help me, because it was some competition between workers that the best will win, and it will end up that I quit this job in this company. I started to look for something else, because I don't believe in capitalism then and now, it will take me to socialism and communism. I find your channel, and 2 years ago or something more, and I was communist when I was maybe 40-50 years old. It was time when I was interested in these things, because my grandfather was a soldier who fight fascist groups after war in Poland, and this history told me to study history of People Republic of Poland, of communism in Poland, of USSR. But this when I go to next step in education in Poland, I turned to capitalist point of view, because I believed that I will make very big success, because it is capitalism is known for this, that make the people to believe that it is very easy, or it is very big probability that you will make success in capitalist world. And as young young man, I believed in this, and as I say, I stopped to believe in this, and it threw me to socialism, to communism, because I hate my boss, I hate my work, I hate my hard work, because it don't give me nothing, nothing. It is a very small amount of money which I earn. Where is the success that propaganda is showing in television, in internet, that if you are smart, if you are hardworking, if you follow your orders of your boss, that it will take you, maybe not for become millionaire, but you will have very good life in capitalist world, because hard work is profitable. No, it is not, simply not true, and there it is, frustration which grown in me. It take me to socialism, and I have many talk with you on channel of Polish channel A Bit of Communism, and this set up my view to communism.
Okay, so now I have another question for you. Comrade Rafał is the founder of the Rebirth of Communism portal. It is odrodzenie.fr, which has been in existence for over 2 years. Could you please say something about this portal? What can you find on it? How often new articles appear there? How the portal is created, and what is the reception of the communist medium in Polish society? What articles are the most popular? In what direction will the portal develop, and what to do to make our content more accessible to Poles?
So I started a portal, odrodzenie.fr, which is a part of our movement. First it was YouTube channel, now we have a portal, we have a Facebook, we have a Twitter, we have we are on Reddit, we are on Polish social media, others. So it is growing up, and on our portal, things are right by communist people interested in spreading communism in Poland. It is mostly young people, not educated in this in writing or press, or with experience in press. No, the idea was to make young people, make people not educated to write, because voice of people who are, you know, not educated or didn't have access to media, didn't are capitalist, didn't are successful people in this capitalist world, to write what they think, to write their experiences, to write, maybe this is not how to say it, maybe this is not a masterpiece of writing. There are some errors, some mistakes, some others problems, but we are learning through writing, through experience, and it is profitable for us, because 2 years ago where portal was started, it is this level of advancement was very, very low, and now these people who was 2 years ago when portal was started, they are good in writing. They are good in writing, and they are We are making advance. Yes, so that was idea on this portal, and is still that if new people come to us and want to become editor or writer, we don't have some. We don't need to. This man didn't. It is not needed to. This man have this good writing and experience or studies or something else. So we have now a redaction. We have a section of this redaction. We are developed. And if it come to what people think about this portal, it is very very big spectrum of this. We have leftists who call themselves communists but they are against of movement for many reasons, and they say, how you can make this portal if you don't have education? You are not press. You are not. You have many errors and something else. And this was from beginning. It was 2 years ago. They say you want to make portal, but only two members in your redaction. What do you want to make? You write one text in a week. It is not. It is not today, really press, and this still constantly we hear this. But now we have 5 texts in one day, so 5 texts, 4 texts, to maybe 3 texts in a day. So we make that we are developing, and this we are hit from leftists, yes, as people who. Who should be interested in make a radical leftist portal, because there was in Poland we didn't have some portal like this. We have liberal media, we have many of right-wing media, we have maybe one or two social liberal media, and that's it. So, but no, they are making these opinions to I don't know to make us to quit writing and give up and make right-wing propaganda to spread most and without counterpunch. This is one point of you. We have of course right wing, which is why I am in a mask, because we have in Poland this situation that communism is prohibited by law, not directly. It is not say that if you are communist you go to prison, because communists are repressed. Many portals which were communist was like yours was destroyed by prosecutors and by courts. It is very hard to be communist in Poland, and I don't want to make I don't want to police go and take my laptop, take my telephone, smartphone, and portal will quit. And this right wing and liberal also is why it is communist portal in Poland. Who allowed to this? Where is police? Take it down. They want to ask to go to prison, and this capitalist right wing, like capitalist, like conservatives, it is liberal, like we have in English world the BBC and so on is on it. TVN in Poland, they also want us to go to prison. because it is very hard to be communist in Poland because of this. So this is, but we have also people who are very happy to from our very happy because there is this portal on Polish internet, and it is not only right wing and liberal, but it's also a radical leftist communist portal, and people can read it, can learn something different from other from communist point of view, and it is we can. We can destroy these lies about communism, which is spread in Poland by government or by others, and they join us. They want to help. They want to make something reports what to do in portal, what change to make it better, and. That's it. There's some other question with that, which I don't answer.
I would like to add that in this situation in Poland, where the communism is persecuted, where the anti-communists all the time they shout, "Where is police?" The prosecutor have to ban this channel and the reduction of odrodzenie.fr. Went sent to prison. One of our ex collaborator who wrote some shitty articles to our site, when he split with us, when he sent us a letter that you have to delete my articles from this site internet. If not, I will demand the persecutor to ban your seat. So we in this example we see the sectarianism of the so-called true Marxist, true communists who don't they don't have shame to use the police or persecutor to fight with other communists but we will not speak about them. We will not say they name today, maybe later if he continue the make fight with us. Okay, so maybe now third question. Now let's move on to our party. Me and you and other are the founding members are communists. No, wait. Me, you, and the other founding members are communists. Could you please tell me why the party is named this way, Polish Workers' Party? Why is there nothing in the name of the party about revolution or communism? How do you assess the possibility of reaching the masses with the communist program in today's Poland, on the example of Communist Party of Poland?
So we, as a Polish Workers' Party, are looking to tradition, to legacy of Polish Workers' Party, which was set in Poland during World War II. And it was called the Polish Workers' Party as like now. And there is Polish Communist Party in Poland, which is dead, which is not doing anything. It is not necessary to Communist Party to have this word communist in a name. We have workers, and the workers are the most revolutionary class, like the classic says. Yes. So it is, and it has another. I'm looking for a word. meaning, another meaning that why workers? Because we want plenty to people who join us party. We want them to be our workers. We want to build a party from our workers. No, it is in Poland we didn't have some party. And it was very important in many communist party in the world that there is party, but this party is created from intellectuals mostly, and this is not a revolutionary party, but because these intellectuals maybe write something wise, maybe are educated, but they are not revolutionary because their lives in capitalist system is moderate. It is not so bad like workers, and they are in a paper they are interested in revolution, to say about this, but did they nor they are not so motivated to change this system in their countries. And which class is most interested in this change? Which class is poor, which class is most which is which class is the most exploited in this system? This is workers' party, it is workers' class. So if there is no workers in a party, and this party call themselves communist, this is not communist party, in my opinion. So this is why we have this name of our party. And I forgot another question. Can you?
Okay. Maybe I will add something to think which you say. I think the most important to understand what is Polish Workers' Party is the word dignity, that we want to build the dignity for the workers, because in my opinion in the most the leftist organization which existed in Poland today, but not only in Poland but in the many of the Western countries, we have the situation that in the parties, leftist parties, this structure of the society, which society is divided to the elites, privileged elites, and the people from the bottom, the workers, is reproduced in this party. That in this party there are also always very educated people, very often from the privileged layers of the society, from the bourgeoisie or from the intelligentsia. They are educated. They are many of them also knew very good the Marxist theory. But the problem is that after, when they try to build the organization, Marxist organization, communist organization, they tried to organize the people from our class, the workers. The workers came to the meeting and they are not the subject of this meeting. They have to only listen and learn from the intelligentsia how they should to think, that it is somebody from the upper class, from the who is well educated, it's him who is the leader. The most important example of party like this, it is a lot of parties built by Piotr Ikonowicz in Poland. He is the politician, he is professional politician from all his life. He started his political activity in 1970s, and all the time he repeats the same strategy, that he is educated, he he organized people from the bottom. For example, now in Poland he have organization which is the name Movement for the Social Justice. And we have to say that in this party there are many people very poor. This is the people who were evicted. The problem with the homeless people, and Ilkonovich helped them to find a new house, or he stopped the eviction. He wants to build the people, the party where are the poor people, but these poor people, there are only there for listening Ikonovich, listening other members of intelligentsia, and we are against it. We want to build the party for the workers, which workers are respected, like there, with their problem. If the workers don't want to speak about the social minorities, we don't speak about this. If the workers don't want to build the Communist Party, who all the time are speaking, we have to fight with the Catholic religion, we have to fight with I don't know what. No. Other leftist group, they are make this agenda. We want to be one party which always defend workers, because in Poland there are not party like this, and in the time of the corona crisis all the parties which existed, also leftist party, also the party of Ikonovich, and also the Communist Party of Poland, they said that in the time of crisis we have to take money from the budget of the state to help the bourgeoisie. Everybody said that we need to help the bourgeoisie or the entrepreneurs, and nobody said a word to help the workers. And we are the only one who said that no, the most important is help the workers.
Yes, we did come to social minorities when it comes to people who say we need to protect minorities at all costs. So this is the moment when I ask, what about capitalists? They are also minorities. You want to protect them also? And it is some liberal thinking in some leftist, and we need to make it clear that yes, we want to protect some minorities, but it is not at all cost, and every minority, so like it in the liberals. So I am agreeing with you in this topic.
Okay, now let's move to another question. One of the first actions organized by the Polish Workers' Party was a picket in front of the Spanish embassy. Can you say who is Pablo Hasél and why the PPR is in solidarity with him?
Pablo Hasél, it is a Spanish musician, rapper. Who make a statement against the monarchy in Spain, because it is the monarchy state, they have king, and because of that he say this king is defrauder, he defraud the money, he is a liar, he is a criminal, and like this. And this was one of the reasons why this he was arrested in Spain, and we make a solidarity action. Our members go to Warsaw to embassy of Spain, and we made a small demonstration to solidarity with Spanish communist against this monarchy in Spain, and so on.
Oh, and against repression of the communists in all the European Union, because all the time the European Union wants to show to other countries that here we have democracy, we have the liberty of the freedom of speech, freedom of press, and when the communists try to use the freedom of speech, they say, oh, no, it is freedom of speech, but not for you, it is not for communists, because you are the communists, and and that's all. Okay, new question. I have a lot of questions for you, Kamrat Trafo. The PPR, it is Polish Workers' Party in Polish, Polska Partia Robotnicza. So the PPR also organized a rally in memory of the victims of the cursed soldiers. Who are the cursed soldiers? Does contemporary capitalist Poland remember the thousands of victims of these lousy bandits? Who introduced the cult of the cursed soldiers, and how did Polish social democracy vote in this matter?
So, cursed soldiers, this is the name for a group of people, of some gangs, after World War II, after 45, that was in Poland and want to fight legal state which was created after war in Poland, after peace. People want to work, people want to rebuild their cities, people want to rebuild factories to make country working, and they go to a forest and make some small military actions to fight this fight against what they call communism, but they don't kill communism, they kill civilians, they kill people of others nationalities, like Belarusians, because they like Lithuanian people and so on, because they it was like this this the territories was these territories was put in like Belarus, Soviet Republic, Lithuanian, because these territories was mostly Lithuanian people who lived there, and they don't agree with that, so they go to the village and kill all of the people which lived there to make their protest against this changing of borders in Poland, to make it more ethnic by borders by divided by ethnics. If it is more Lithuanian in some territory, so it will go to Lithuanian Soviet Republic. And before a war, it was great territory of Poland, but this Poland has many territories was after war with young Soviet Russia was territories in these territories lived mostly people another nationalities, and but it was some imperialism of Polish people, and it was one of their actions. They didn't agree with participation of land to peasants, like my grandfather take a land from this participation, and these groups will go to this village where this participation of land is taking place, and kill these peasants kill civilians, kill children, and so on. And today, the government is making them a heroes because they fight communism. These murders of many, many people is like 5,000 people killed, civilians, from sorry, by these groups. And
Wait. I will add something, and after you will continue. The professor Bruno Drwenski, he made a lecture which you can find in this channel in English about all these crimes made by the cursed soldiers, and he speak about the number much more bigger. It's 20,000, not 5,000, but 20,000 of the victims. So I would like to say one thing, that the cursed soldiers, it is the definition for the all people who continue the fight against the new Polish state after the finish of the war. Part of these people, it was the member of the guerrilla, which was collaborated with the bourgeois government in exile in London. So it was part of them. It was the guerrilla movement, which again, in the time of war, they make a war, they fight against Germans, against Nazis, and after they start to fight against the Polish state and the Russian army. But the most important, which I want to say, that part of the second part of this cursed soldier, it is the extreme right, the people who in the time of the Second World War collaborated with Gestapo, who killing the Jews who are escaping the ghettos, Jews who are escaping the concentration camp, they were killed by this fascist. They collaborated with Gestapo, they giving information about the Polish Red Guardia of the people, the partisans of the socialist partisans, and they made many, many bad things. The one of the example is the Brigada Świętokrzyska NSZ, who are in the time when the Soviet army, they cross the Vistula River, they started to retreat in the hand with the Wehrmacht. They starting going west. So it is the best example of collaboration, this fascist with the fascist from the Germany. And after Second World War, together, the cursed soldiers, it was never united front of these bandits. But we have to say that today this propaganda which speak about them, all these people, they glorify like true heroes, because the most danger for the Polish, it is the communism, it is the Soviet army, and everybody who are fighting against communists is the Polish hero. And it is not important that he collaborated with Gestapo, it is not important that he killed the Poles. The most important is this is the fight against communism. And so the cursed soldiers, it was the fanatic, anti-communist fanatic, but today the propaganda, the people who are building this propaganda in the Institute of the National Remembrance, they are also the fanatic, true fanatic anti-communist.
Yes, in this IPN, Instytut Pamięci Narodowej, like you said, remember, this institute have in their ranks really fascists, former fascists. You can, in Polish media, we also will write about this in a that in this institute who protect who prize these cursed soldiers. They hired a fascist for be a regional director of section of this institute. So what I want to say of cursed soldiers, for many historians it is hard to recognize if some group of people who rob, who fight in forest, who have weapons, killed party members, it is cursed soldiers, it is this right-wing movement of anti-communism and fighting freedom, so-called in Poland, or it is something gang, robbers who didn't have any ideology but they want to kill, to rob, exploited this post-war disorder and make money about this. And so this is the situation in Poland, and like you say, this these groups was extreme right wing. They want to, some of these leaders of these groups wanted in Poland after war create some like theocracy, some kind of Catholic theocracy in our country. So they wanted to start a third world war after Second World War, because they think that they will convinced USA and the United States. So after you killed Hitler and destroyed Nazis, you should now attack USSR, because we lost our lands, we just participated to farmers, to peasants, these communists take our fabrics, factories, our capital, and so on, and make this war. We are unhappy about this, and so. This is history about these cursed soldiers, and something like 10 years ago, in Polish parliament, it was they made something like cursed soldiers remembers day. And it is very important to notice there that social democracy, like today it is called Razem, SLD, or
Wiosna. You left. Now they are unified. Wiosna and SLD. Now it's,
yes,
you left.
This, there are.
You left old shit.
Yes, and they vote to make this National Remembrance Day of these cursed soldiers who killed civilians, who killed mothers with children, who killed Belarusians, who killed Lithuanians, who didn't want to peace after World War II. And this is the status of social democracy in Poland. They are fascist. They prize fascist. No, now they say sorry, we didn't think about it. Now we didn't want this National Day of Remembrance, and so on. So like, you know, one day you vote for this, and some years later, if communists make this like us, like our party and us, show that they are criminal, they were they are criminals and so on, fascist, and then they now they say so sorry, we didn't know, and blah, blah, blah. So this is very very popular in Polish social democracy, that they vote something which is against socialism, which is anti-communism, like war in Iraq, others wars, and so on. They vote for, And now they say, oh, sorry, we didn't know. And this is very, very popular in Polish social democracy. They are left wing of fascism, which was what we say about them. We make a demonstration in Warsaw against the scare soldiers. We have read out loud by microphone victims, all victims, this is not all, but many victims by name, by where, by how they were killed by cursed soldiers, and we make it loud. People come and hear us. So you can watch this on Polish channel and stand, and then they agreed. They with their heads, yes, they very very pleased. But so that we do this. So this is a war action, and we will continue this, like liquidation of this IPN, which is fascist institute, liquidate this National Day of Remembrance, and make Polish people to remember that these cursed soldiers, they are not heroes, they are murderers, they want another war, they are another victims, another million of dead of Poles who will probably die in this war because they lost their lands, they lost their capital and factories and so on.
I would like to add that in Germany we have law which is forbidden in German to speak something good about Hitler. And the law, similar law we can find in Belarus. If you say something positive about the Romuald Reisbury, who make a ethnic cleansing in the Podlasie region, where he killed people because of their religion, because of their Orthodox religion, or because of their they speaking Belarusian language, he killed all these people there. And in Poland, he is the hero. And in Belarus, if you want to say something good about him, it is the same punishment which is in Germany for praying a Hitler. So we see how it is that the things which we are say, and when we criticize the Polish government, it is not because we are the stupid and we are crazy. No. This is the Polish government is crazy. The Polish government today, he make the propaganda which he take all these people very, very... Romuald Reisbury, it is very... It is the killer.
What I want to say about Belarus. Last year, when it was the last time when it was this National Day for Remembrance in Belarus, in Belarus school, there was a Polish teacher who made something like remembers of these war cursed soldiers and this. Good remember this Bury. So imagine that in Belarus school, in Belarus land, in Belarus, among the Belarus people, come something, some Polish right wing propagandist and say there are hero who was anti-communist, but this man killed this Belarus because they were Belarus and won't take this Belarus land to Poland. And what come? Belarusians expelled this teacher from the Republic of Belarus. If I remember, it was some persecution. And
they expelled the Polish consul who was there. And this teacher was condemned, he was arrested. arrested.
Yes.
And after this, because he is the she is the citoyen of the Belarus, because in Belarus there are 1 million people who are Polish. It is the one of the it is the only country in the world where the right of the Polish minority are respected. In not in in any other countries in Western Europe, in USA, where are also big minority of Polish, there are not this law which respect Poles like minorities. If the Polish children go to the school in USA, to France, Germany, or United or England, they have there are not any autonomy linguistic. They have to learn only language which is there. In Belarus, we have autonomy linguistic. The Polish citizen of the Belarus, which are Poles, they can send their children to school where they can learn in Polish. But the Polish propagandists use it to spread the fascist propaganda. So it's too much for the Belarus government, and I totally support the Belarus government and Belarus police that when they arrested the Polish fascists in Belarus, I give bravo, and we want also made these things in Poland.
Yes, and what happened in Poland after this? All liberal media, even social liberal media, right-wing media, so on. Why this Belarusian government do this? They persecute Poles, and so on. Dictatorship. What happened here? Buri was a hero, but Belarus people lived and
anarchist,
know that this Buri was murdered.
One of the leader of the anarchists, he also he made a video against Belarus in this time.
Yeah, so it was this situation of very good for Belarus to have this government, and I also applaud to this.
Okay, Comrade Rafał, I prepared for you another free question. So I
okay.
Hope that we are finished soon. But our conversation is very interesting, and so we don't have to hurry. We have to continue good discussion. In April, the PPR conducted an information campaign against NATO. Can you say why the PPR is seeking Poland withdrawal from NATO? Why is the PPR against the occupation of Poland by American troops? What does the Polish left think about Poland's presence in NATO?
So in Poland we have another problem, which all political parties, all movements, official are pro-NATO and pro-West. They didn't see any mistakes made by NATO, by the West, and why NATO is exist after 89 and so on. So we made this campaign, and we write a couple of articles about crimes do by NATO troops, crimes do by American troops. Why NATO is even exist after 89 if the main goal of NATO was to be opposition force to Warsaw Pact or Soviet Union, and Soviet Union was collapsed and the Warsaw Pact was disbanded, but NATO exists still. So it was very good article why even NATO after this collapse of Soviet Union was Poland and the rest of Eastern countries was joined this NATO. So very good article by Bruno Dreski, Professor Bruno Dreski on our website. And we want to make people think about this. Americans are not angels, are not saviors. We are not in danger of any Russian aggression. The American are aggressor, not Russia, not Belarus, and so on. We want made to clear that America is responsible for many, many wars, and these wars were made for money, for profits, for oil, for other resources, and so on. And it is crimes against civilians, like Agent Orange in Vietnam. Crimes made by Western countries and their supporters, their allied forces. Like Israel now is making many, many crimes against Palestinian people. And we think this is important because all political powers, all media in Poland show us Americans as these good people who come here. And we have, and please, the American, please come to Poland because we are in danger. Yes. So this is all lies. We made it clear that what is NATO, that Poland, what this is PPR, PPR, that PPR want to make Poland to abandon NATO, want PPR to Polish troops be dispelled from Poland, and what is the stance of Polish social democracy, social liberal media? Sorry, they are also pleased by NATO. They made a holiday this day when it is anniversary Polish joined to NATO. It was an official side by Polish leftist social democracy that very good that Poland is NATO, and we as a real leftist power, and it is very important to say that even some radical leftists like anarchists, like Trotskyists, like other groups, they also didn't say a word against NATO. They also they maybe are against NATO, but they didn't want to say it because they believed in this shit that NATO is a very important thing in Poland, because if there is one no NATO, that and so after one day the Russian troops will be in Warsaw and occupation and very casualties and so on, and Belarus will attack us, and China will attack us, and I don't know, maybe aliens will also attack us, and we will be without help and so on. So it is very important to say that in Poland is in any media it is this propaganda that Russia is a danger to Poland, dangerous to Poland, and we need so this propaganda is so successful that Polish people and Poland is one of the country which are most pro NATO in the European Union and in the world, where the NATO is actually. We want to make this our vision about world without NATO, that there is a criminal organization, that Russia is not threat for us, and so on. After that action from leftist, from right wing, we was called a Russian spy, Russian agents, that the Moscow paid us for write these anti-NATO articles. That's it.
Okay, I would like to add that the Polish social democracy where is in power, it was in 2001, 2005. It is Polish social democracy which sent Polish troops in Afghanistan. It is Polish social democracy which sent Polish troops to Iraq. And it is the Prime Minister of Poland, Leszek Miller, who decided to build in the Poland the secret prison for the CIA, where the people were tortured by the CIA. It is against the Polish law, it is against the European Union law, and normally Leszek Miller should to be go to the prison, but he is protected by United States. I would like to say something, say that Poland is very poor country. And the paradox of Poland is that we are poor country and we are spend a lot of money for the planes, the military planes, which are very, very expensive. So you see the paradox that the one of the poorest countries buy the planes, which are one of the most expensive. And now Poland don't have money for the building hospitals, for helping people. Many Poles are dying because of the epidemic, because of the other things, that the hospitals are crowded because of the people ill to COVID-19. So the other people which are not ill to COVID-19, there are other disease, they are dying like this. In the last year, more than 150,000 Poles were well died because of this. If Poland are not a member of NATO, if we don't buy this American arms, because always this military things it is always produced by the United States, so we are the client who buy. And we don't have money for hospitals and other things. If you want to add something, say. If not, I have other question. Now let's talk about party building. What does the party do? What do you think about Marxists who limit their political activity mainly to quarrels on social media? What do you think of the Marxist, dogmatist and sectarians who contemptuously treat Polish workers who have not yet had the opportunity to read the most important work of Marxist classic? What do you think of the boarding Marxists who strive at all costs for constant divisions in the labor movement?
So if you come to building a party, it is a very hard organizational work, which is divided by our members to invite others to proceed a recruitation process and so on. So we have I will say party in organization. So we are not didn't have program and so on. We are writing this program and we are in half of a way to publish this program, party program. And it was our program was democracy. Built by democracy rules. So we have divisions, many divisions like economic, like and environmental, like labor work, labor right, and so on. And in these divisions was people who wanted to work in this division, and they write down ideas. Write down ideas. What should be in our program? And it was democracy. There was some other ideas, and they were contemporary to others and so on. And there was discussion, very, very long. It take something like even 3 hours a day. People discuss about these ideas, and if there was problem, there was democracy voting by members of this division, which was something divisions like economy. So it take us like 2.5 months to write down and agree with them ideas, and now we will put these ideas in our program. So there will be need to writing to explain why these ideas we want. We must think that this program is not for not only for us, but this program must be for people who will read this program. So for workers, this must be no complicated words, no complicated ideas, no complicated theories like this. Maybe we will understand this, but people who go to the street and we will give here you have a program of Polish People Party, read this program, we want you to be interested in this, and then this man will open this program, read, what the fuck is this? I don't know half of the world you are using this program. No, we didn't want to do this, so now it is another part, other half of work to write down in program. These ideas explained with simple words, with examples, with so not only program for Marxists who are in Poland, not only a program for us to know what are our ideas who drive us and so on. We want this program be to all Poles like was PKWN. After war, during war, it was published, PKWN. This was a program by Polish Polish Workers' Party during a war. So if it come to these people who are so-called orthodox Marxists, and very good theoretician maybe, and if they say us to you didn't read classics, you didn't read 50 plus tomes of Lenin works, every letters who Lenin write, and Marx and Engels and Stalin and so on, and so not sorry, these people are so I call this intellectuals. They are very pleased that but they didn't want to make other people to be wise, to other people to read this and to understand. And in our party, we didn't require from our members to read all these things.
Wait. I would like to add that maybe they are intellectuals, but they are not intelligent. They are narcissistic. And if you want to build the, if you want to spread the Marxism, communism, you have to reach the working class. If you are narcissistic, if you disrespect the people who are the for whom we made this building, this organization, we prepared this revolution, they don't understand that the intellectual is without movement, he is nothing. He is like zero. He is like a petite fly which you can kill like this. So the role of the communist intellectuals is thinking how to prepare ideology to spread in the masses. They don't know how to do this. So maybe in their mind they are very intellectual, but in my mind they are narcissistic and not efficacious. And we see that they are all the time, they are in the very small circles, or maybe not circles, they are individuals, because all the time when they are try to create circles for three person, 2 months later they are quarrels each other, and all the time they are divided like atoms.
Yes, this is true, and we didn't want these people in our organization. Because our organization, we have some rules, which was democratically voted. That is, you need to be nice to other people. You need, if you know more, make your conversation with other people to understand and to give them your wisdom, your third, if you read some books, share with this wisdom with others. We have something in our party, what is maybe I will call the reading room. It is not compulsory, but people can every week we gather and discuss about some book what was to read during last week, and we after this we after the discussion after is this we vote to another book, and this book is need not to be too long because it is only week to read it. It can be article, it can be a couple of articles about on topic. And this is very, very good, because there are people who know very little, who are workers, who are socialists, but they didn't know so much of classics, but they can in a nice atmosphere they can study with others these books, and this is very good. No narcissistic people, no people who want to show how they are wise and others are stupid. No, these people are expelled from the party. They didn't have this collectivism in them. They are individuals and individualistic. They want to others to prize them to something like this, and they didn't know how to live in society. So that's it.
Yes, the Communist Party is not for the people who are egoist and narcissistic. Finally, a question about the future of the PPR. When will the program be announced? When will the website and newspaper be? What would you like the PPR to cooperate with the communist parties from other countries?
So our program will be published in Polish language in 22 July, and it is anniversary of PKWN in 1944, and this day we will also publish our program. It will be translated to English also, so you can read it and give us your opinion. If it comes to website, to other stuff, we want first to write our program, and after that we will run our website. We will start maybe a Facebook website, maybe Twitter account, and others the social media, and maybe we will start also some of newspaper, but it will be like
Um,
information bulletin, newsletter, like what we do, what are problems in Poland, and it will be very, very limited. But if it comes to rebirth of communism and the website odrodzenie.fr, maybe it will. Well, maybe in future we will start some weekly or one in 2 weeks or one in a month magazine, which will be inside this we will find articles which are now in this website, and maybe more theoretical and so on.
And what do
and if it comes to other parties from other countries, we are very interested in make these connections, to cooperate, to know each other, to make support of you. We are active party, not like KPP, Communist Party of Poland, but they do nothing. They are party which is only for being. They literally do nothing. There is maybe one person who do something. The one person who won in the year on the 1st May will go to some place and show red flag, and that's it. That is this party, and I think this is maybe even offensive to other communist parties in the world, that they say they are real party, and I as a Pole I feel I think guilty or something like that we didn't have a strong communist party who can really support others, who can really make connections to make common actions and so on, and it's only Communist Party of Poland which is only on the paper. PPR will be to change this and will be changed this.
I would like to say that now when I started to build this English-speaking channel, I realized that every party, communist party in the world, have an English section. So I can read the statements of the Communist Party of Greece. I can read the statement of communist parties from other countries which I don't know the language. And one word of the criticize you and comrades from odrodzenie.fr, why there are not English section of the odrodzenie.fr?
It is mostly because, as you can see, I am during learning of English, so I will practice. I will maybe talk with you other times. I will talk with other companies, other worlds, other countries, and I will change this. And after our party members will be educated in English, and we can easily make this English section. It is very hard to me to connect this my work, my life, and my work to the party, and to study English. It is very hard to me, so I practice by talking with you. So I think that will be successful for me, and you can in future you will see English section.
Yes. It's not for me English section. It is for the communists from other countries. Yes. Because when we started to have this English section, the collaboration of the communists and the workers from all over the world will be much more easier. Because today we speak a lot of about the internationalism, but we don't have any cooperation, real cooperation from the communist parties from other countries. We have a little contact with the YouTuber YouTube channel creators of the other organizers like this, but I think that when we want to create party, we also like a party have the contact with other parties. Like this, we will be stronger, and together we can organize the fight against bourgeoisie much more professional.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, comrade. It was very good surprise for me. Your English is better than mine, and I thought that it will be very quick discussion because of the linguistic problem, but your English is very, very good. And we have to all the time learn and practice.
Yes.
Okay, so I will finish this.